Work in tonight for Joe, and it became pretty active around some areas.
Skies, yeah, just to get feisty in the past couple of hours, but not before we hit 92 degrees. Another pretty toasty, warm day out there, all things considered. Here's a look outside as we are at our KOAT studios, peeking at the mountains there. And we did have some storms kind of settle right into the Tijeras Canyon weekend, but oh, did they throw some wind gusts our way. Let's give you a look at what's happening right now. Live radar scanning the skies there on the West Mesa. This storm in the East Mountains has weakened. There's another one basically out on top of Moriarty. An up close look at the metro right now, basically rain free. Still may have some leftover showers and sprinkles in the Carnoel area, but that storm again weakening. The damage is already kind of done. We'll talk more about some flash flooding in just a moment here. But active skies on the East Mountains, plenty of storms over the Sangre de Cristos, and look at all the wet weather right now on top of that I-25 corridor. Out here in cattle country, there is cause for hope. At least a few of these storms will probably regenerate and continue to push to the south and east. So there will be some drenching rains, and we do have a little bit of rain around Clovis and Portales. The Socoto area, it's kind of been off and on storming all afternoon with a few more just about set to roll off the Manzanos and into Socoto and over west central New Mexico. Yeah, we've had storms kind of off and on throughout the day in the Gila Wilderness and around Silver City, and there are some flood advisories for that area as well. Now, here's what we have on the watch and warning map. All the areas lit up in green. That's where we do have flood advisories on the clock for another hour or two, and that red box right there in the East Mountains, that's where we still do have a flash flood warning until 6:30. August, a bit of a disappointer, at least at the Albuquerque Sunport after a very wet July, August, more than an inch below average. Our yearly total there stuck at 3.89. We should be well over 6 inches by now at this point in the calendar year. 84 degrees the latest temperature. And look at that top of the hour wind here at 5 o'clock. 31 sustained gusting to 52. That is just a temporary wind number, but yeah, it just gives you an idea how strong those winds were. A rain cooled air over north central and northeastern New Mexico. Still in the mid 80s in Albuquerque. Still unsettled enough to where skies could storm on us, and where we did stay dry, it's almost 100 in Carlsbad. Here's your planner for the Albuquerque Metro. Can't rule out some thunder, and easterly breezes will be persistent overnight. I think we wake up tomorrow to 69 degrees, and it is going to take a while for these evening showers and thunderstorms to finally wind down, but I bet by the time we wake up tomorrow morning, most of the action will have subsided. Tomorrow afternoon, going to be another pretty active one in the storm department across most of the state. We look ahead towards Tuesday, still expecting unsettled skies, but by the time we're talking Wednesday, I think this moisture is going to be working itself back into Arizona. So here's your outlook in the Four Corners. Looks like Monday, Tuesday, still some scattered showers and storms, then drier, hotter for the week's end. Southwestern New Mexico, looking at pretty good chances for storms tomorrow, not as active Tuesday. By Wednesday, Thursday, you also see that drying trend in southeastern New Mexico. Looks like the heat will finally break by tomorrow. It's only going to be low 90s. Isolated storms going to be possible. Northeastern New Mexico, we expect high temperatures right around 80 degrees. Still a chance for storms through Wednesday. You're going to have to wait until Thursday before skies do dry out. And coming up in Santa Fe on Thursday, it's Zozobra time. Could have storms. Good chances actually Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, just a few showers, and I think it will be dry for Thursday's Zozobra. In the metro, more afternoon storms possible tomorrow. It's going to be upper 60s tonight and then up near 90 tomorrow afternoon. Tuesday, another day with storms. Just want to point out Wednesday, that's when storm chances decrease big time. 85 our average high temperature by the middle of the week, and you can see by the end of the week, Shelley, we are talking high temperatures at or above average with lots of sunshine for several days. You were kind of saying earlier, the heat, it's wearing on you a little bit.
Over 90. I like it 80 too.
Well, we'll be closer to 90 than 80, but probably not seeing any more 90s for a while.